going, it's Jack Long here from learnguitartunes.com. So, Paradise City, Guns N' Roses, second Guns N' Roses lesson then, after the huge successful lesson of mine, Sweet Child of Mine. Now, if you haven't done so already, down below there in the description of this video below, there's a link. Click on it and it'll take you to my website. You can become a member, completely free, learnguitartunes.com/members. And every new member will get, not one, but two free ebooks. So go and pick yourselves up a free learnguitartunes.com ebook down there. And yeah. So I'm going to show you the main kind of intro into the song. For those of you who have got beady eyes, you may have noticed I did two actual different versions there. Well, two kind of versions doing different chords, really. It's quite an easy version, quite an easy intro as well. Nicely done on acoustic. And I'll show you two versions and a little tiny hammer-on riff in there as well. And the chords that I'm going to show you pretty much fit the whole of the song as well. I'm going to zoom in now, do the lesson, let's get on with it, and hope you enjoy it. Cheers. Okay, so Paradise City, Guns N' Roses, close up then for the lesson. So I'm going to show you a set of two different versions how to play it. They're both very easy, but one is slightly more difficult than the other. So let's show you, first of all, the chords. So here's the first chords. It starts on a G. Both versions I'll show you both start on a G. Okay, the G I'm playing, you probably notice I've got my pinky on the E string and my ring finger on the B string of the third fret. And of course there's no capo, we're capo free today. And then I'm just playing a G chord as normal. For those of you who don't know what a G chord is, you need to go and click below, get yourself my ebook, and it will show you how to play a G chord. Right. G chord, so it starts off like that. Now this is for the ultra easy version. So G. Stay in that shape, just drop down to what is a C additional 9. So exactly the same shape, you're just now dropping your middle finger off the E down to an A on the third fret, and index finger off the A down to the D or the second fret. Okay, and those remain there. So that's the next chord. C additional 9. And we're gonna kind of do this F additional kind of chord. It's like an F but with the additional on it. So again, all you're doing is you're just dropping down from there to then there. So this time, middle finger comes off the A, goes onto the D of the third, and your index finger comes off the D of the second and goes onto the G of the second. Okay, so one more time. G, and just drop down. C additional 9, and drop down again to like a F additional 9, kind of, not really, but it is. Alright, so there are your chords. So it's G, 2, 3, 4, C additional 9, 2, 3, 4. G, 3, 4, and again, 2, 3, 4, down to the C shape, 1, 3, 4, then the next one, the F kind of shape, back to the C and the G. Okay, now for the slightly harder version, starts with the G again, G, 2, 3, 4, then we're going to be doing a C. And when you do a C, you're going to remove pretty much all your fingers, apart from a pinky. And those of you who can play a C are probably going, why do I need my pinky when I play a C? Well, I'm going to show you. So G, 2, 3, 4, and into a C. And instead of this doing a normal C, what we're doing is we're playing our C with our pinky on the third fret of the high E string, right? So, for those who can't play a C, go and get my ebook, and then just to add a little extra note onto that C, we're going to be placing our pinky onto that E string there on the third fret. So you can hear that ringing all the way through it. So it's G, that ringing, and the C, it's ringing all the way through the song, it's clever. Okay, remain the pinky there,
and remain your index finger there, and you're just going to be moving these two fingers down a notch into an F shape. Okay, so this, I call this F, easy F. Whenever I'm teaching a student to play an F, the hardest F really is the bar chord F. But again, we're keeping our pinky here on this third fret of this of the E string. Ringing. Okay, so there are your chords. So it's G, C with the pinky, F with the pinky, back to C, and G. So let's run through those chords now with the count of four. So G, two, three, four, and a C, two, three, four, and an F, two, C, two, G, two. Let's go through the counting and the rhythm of that, the structure now, for both, and this works for both of the chords I've just shown you. So it's G, which is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, and then the F is always a 2, F, 1, 2, C, 1, 2, and a G, 2, 3, 4, so G, 2, 3, 4, and a 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and a G, 2, now a slightly harder version. G, 2, 3, 4, and a C, 2, 3, 4, and an F, 2, back to C, 3, 4, G. So now for the picking. And the picking I'm going to show you is exactly the same for both of the chords, depending on which one you prefer to play out of those sets of chords, okay? The picking. Now, whenever you're applying picking to chords, and you starting off with a strum, you always want to start off the strum with the main bassier part of the picking. So on a G, you're always going to start with this E and A. So what am I doing there? So it's a mega close up. So when you're in your G chord, you do G, kind of try and strum. You can strum the whole of the G if you want. As soon as you strum that once, down, you're then doing E, B, G, 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 like that, so, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so you do those very quickly, E, B, G, E, B, G, E, B, G, so you do the E, B, G 3 times. Because the strum counts as one, and then the three BGs, each are a count of one as well, so that you obviously do them 3 times. 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's on the F, we just do it once. One strum, one EBG. And then back to the C. One strum, one EBG, G. Exactly the same on the other set of chords. F, 1, E, B, G, C, 1, E, B, G, G. Now, when you're doing it, when you start it off, you'll probably be very precise with your E, B, G, but as you're going across, you can kind of bring in other strings as well if you're picking. So what I did was, on the G for example, I'm going G, E, B, G, E, B, G, E, B, G. And I go A, D, and as I'm lifting that off to change the chord, hit the D as an open note, and then I strum down. And the reason why is because you've just hit the A and the D as 2 separate notes. The D is an open note, and next time you hit the D, you're strumming down, but this time your index finger is now on there, so it's no longer an open note. It adds a bit more depth into the song. Thank you. I'm going up now. I do the F, E, B, G. Then I do D. So I go D, open. Then I hit the A as I'm coming onto the C, which is now on the third fret. So mix it around a bit when you're doing your chords. You don't just stick to the E, B, G. You can bring in these little, you know, fills by adding the few extra notes on the G, E, B, G, E, B, G, E, B, G, A, D as an open, then into the C shape. And then lastly, at the end of the riff, as you're coming back to the G, hammer on and pull off, which I'm doing. G. So what I'm doing there is, so I go up to that G, as you saw. I then hit an open note on the G, and I hammer with my index finger down on the second fret of the G, and then I pick off. So it's open, hammer, pick off. Like that. It's quite tricky. Try it. So when you pick it, hammer, and then you see I'm kind of bending the string to then pick off, which then makes it an open note again, like this. So you repeat it exactly the same as you go from the G and do exactly the same again on the D string as well, like this. And then on the D string, G, and then straight into a G chord as soon as you do that. Watch. So you do all this bit first. And it's when you come back to the G, you do one E, B, G, and then you do the... EBG. And it works also on the other way. Show you. Hit a few extra strings there because I'm doing a kind of close up here with the old pick. So
okay, so the strumming pattern for this song, starting from the G, down, down, up, down, up, down, down, and down, down, up, down, 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 up, down, down, and down, down. Then, so you do just two down downs, and then you do the riff. Click on the link, get yourself an ebook. Hope you enjoyed the lesson, and I'll see you in the next lesson now. Cheers, bye.